रिफॉर्म्स इन रेगुलर एजुकेशन. अकॉर्डिंग टू माई एनालिसिस कंपेयरिंग विद द लीगल एजुकेशन सिस्टम इन ग्लोबल कंट्रीज, रिफॉर्म्स कैन बी इनिशिएटेड इन लीगल एजुकेशन आर फर्स्ट वन द क्वालिटी असेसमेंट एजेंसी फॉर लीगल एजुकेशन. फर्स्ट वन क्वालिटी असेसमेंट एजेंसी फॉर लीगल एजुकेशन. The quality of legal education in UK is maintained by the general scheme of quality assurance, which is also applicable to the other disciplines. The central agency is the quality assurance agency, which oversees comparability and transparency of the university education in the whole United Kingdom. The new program was launched in 2001 by the agency in order to establish clear and accurate information on the level of training, the character and the outcomes of university education. The agency sets out benchmarks and standards of awarding degree at the different levels, and it has mechanism to inspect the United Kingdom universities. Research assessment exercise, which is particularly known as RAE, is a common method of evaluating research of the UK universities. Full form RAE is Research Assessment Exercise. RAE is concerned about evaluation of output of individual departments of the universities in terms of publications of academic staff, experiments and infrastructure facilities, and publications of journals and books. RAE is a four-yearly process for assessment of the quality of teaching. There is a separate system which is known as TQA, that is Teaching Quality Assessment. In a similar way, permanent quality assurance agency can be established to set out benchmarks and standards of awarding law degrees and to inspect colleges and universities in India. Second point is leading learning in place of rote learning. Practice of rote learning was equally prevalent in country's top schools. Rote learning means what is written in the book is swallowed as such. This is rote learning, and you reproduce the same thing in the answer paper also. The system of rote learning was put in place by the British during colonial rule as a way to suppress critical thinking. The rotten procedure of memorize, write and repeat. This is the procedure in rote learning. Memorize, write and repeat commences in schools and continues in colleges. Most of the school students population adopt for overnight study to get passed and to pass away the papers. Leaders of education has to focus on leading learning legal education in India needs reforms that would support the establishment of global law schools combining the best traditions of public educational institutions with the needed flexibility, freedom, all within the public good framework of a non-profit endeavor. Third point is the teaching pedagogy. Third point in reforms in legal education is teaching pedagogy. The innovation in teaching law may revolutionize our legal system. There are different methods. Socrates case, that is dialogue method of law teaching, then that is known as Socratic case, dialogue method of dot teaching. It can be preferred for lecture method in imparting provision ingredients, knowledge of law, classrooms instead of merely accepting the decision has to discuss why element of the decision of the cases. In this this type of Socrates case, a question should be asked why this happens, and student has to answer to the why question. It is unlike the traditional lecture method. For making this type of law teaching effective, there must be competent and committed faculty. Then teachers has to implement three simple practices, that is planning, assessment and accountability. The law schools of the future are to provide academic space for engaging in teaching and cutting edge research on issues of global significance. Fourth ingredient is technological support. In delivering higher education and transmission of knowledge, technological support by internet facilities, intranet, video conferencing, PowerPoint presentation is increasingly used in the UK universities. Learning IT skills is now considered as a necessary part of legal education. Mere boredom blackboard classes can be revolutionized as smart classroom with support of technological support. Technological support has magnetic power to attract the student toward academic development. Frequent law seminars, students' law journals such as were practiced in US, innovative moot court competitions shall have ability to mold our student to face legal education system in globalized countries. And fifth one is a full-term JD mod system. JD mod means Juris Doctor. Full-term JD mod system. This is followed in US. As followed in US Juris Doctor mode of legal education system, full-time legal education may be provided. The emphasis may be provided on the interested law subjects of students. Instead of 20 compulsory subjects, focus may be made on relevant subjects according to the profession opted by the students. At present, the court practice is entirely different from the academic subject learned in the institution. This happens because of the problems in our present system of law teaching. The first year of law course may emphasize on basic law subjects, and the successive years may focus on the interested disciplinary field of student, and perfect knowledge can be attained by the student in that relevant field so that student may not lose spans of years in search of his profession. Sixth point is vocational stage of legal education. There are two main categories of legal profession in England and Wales: barristers and solicitor. You know what's the difference between a barrister and solicitor? The law students who wish to practice law must select one of the two options for profession and apply for entry and complete the vocational stage. The vocational stage places a strong emphasis upon practical skills that lawyers require. Now, we must differentiate who is a solicitor and who is a barrister. In England and Wales, law society and professional body representing solicitors requires those who wish to qualify to join legal practice course. Those who wish to practice legal practice course is known as solicitors. If they successfully pass this, they will have to obtain a training contract from solicitors firm, which will provide them 2 further years training. before a successful law student is finally admitted as a solicitor or entered on the role of solicitors. The legal practice course lasts one academic year. This legal practice course can be called as LPC in short form. This LPC involves compulsory study of some substantive subjects: accounts, taxation, company law, and professional conduct. The skills of interviewing, drafting, and negotiation are also studied and examined. Upon successfully completing the LPC, a trainee solicitor enters a firm and continues on the job training for further 2 years. This period includes formal training in advocacy. Thereafter, all solicitors are obliged to continue compulsory professional development, which can be achieved by obtaining credit for the attended accredited courses which update legal knowledge or procedure or otherwise inform the practice of law. Then next we can analyze who is a barrister. In England and Wales, the General Council of the Bar has franchised a 1 year program and examination called Bar Vocational Course, BVC, for those wishing to become barristers. The course utilizes practical exercises for the competencies in drafting, research, advocacy, interviewing, and negotiation. Upon successfully passing the bar exams, a student can be called to the bar by his or her in of court. Call to the bar, however, does not entitle automatically a barrister to practice, because barrister must complete a further 12 months pupillage in a group of barristers, office or chambers of barristers in order to appear in court. As followed in UK and many Asian countries, vocational courses and apprenticeship courses has to be held mandatory in addition to theoretical academic courses. This course may award the juniors running to look for case diaries for a year and then try to practice to pray for time in next year. Their confrontation with courts takes and absorbs few years in their life cycle. The juniors are all the way struggling to learn from their seniors with lesser remuneration, and they have to play the role of dependents to their parents even after their age of majority for their bread and butter. The vocational courses through law institutions will better provide the platform to live their life in their younger age, not that of older age. The vocational courses may provide efficient training in DRAIN program, as in UK. DRAIN can be expanded to drafting, research, advocacy, interviewing, and negotiation. That is called a DRAIN. Then seventh point is continuing legal education. Seventh point, continuing legal education. As implemented in Philippines and many Asian countries, continuing legal education has to be made mandatory. In the advent of new amendments and upcoming precedents, lawyers are in need to update the legal education in order to provide better remedies and reliefs to the clients approaching them. The compulsory continuing legal education system may train up these lawyers to dominate in the global legal world.